Residents of Cagayan bracing for the effects of Jenny. Our very own Harris Julio now joins us with the latest. Harris, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, Cagayanos are gearing up for the possible effect of Typhoon Jenny. In a video shared by Barangay Cagawad J.O. Arirao, operators and fishermen in the coastal town of Calayan have strategically positioned and secured their boats in elevated areas. Since yesterday, maritime activities have come to a halt as venture into the sea is strictly prohibited due to formidable waves and adverse weather conditions. Calayan is currently under overcast skies. There is also a surge in the wind, according to Arirao. Classes from kindergarten to grade 12 in private and public schools in the entire province of Cagayan are suspended. Meanwhile, a video by Dennis Ballesteros Valdez captures the crashing of large waves on Balugan Beach in the town of Basco, Batanes. According to Governor Marilu Cayco, they are currently grappling with strong winds and rain. This morning, the Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management convened to strategize for potential impacts of Typhoon Jenny. The provincial government has advised residents to prepare and be cautious. Classes at all levels of schools have also been suspended there since yesterday. That's the details here. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Harris Julio, there joining us on the line. The latest on Typhoon Jenny, which has slightly weakened while moving northwestward over the Philippine Sea. Let's get an update now from ABS-CBN resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel, over to you.
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. Typhoon Jenny slightly weakened and slowed down as it moves closer to the extreme northern Luzon. At 10 this morning, Jenny was located 330 kilometers east of Basco, Batanes, with maximum winds of 155 kilometers per hour and gusts up to 190 kilometers per hour. It is currently moving northwestward at 10 kilometers per hour. Tropical cyclone wind signal number 2 is in effect over Batanes, while wind signal number 1 is hoisted in Cagayan, including Babuyan Islands, northern and eastern Isabela, Apayao, northeastern Abra, northern Kalinga, and the whole Ilocos Norte. PAGASA says signal number 3 is the highest possible warning that will be raised. All types of sea vessels are not allowed to sail in the areas under wind signals 2 and 1. And apart from strong winds along with the rest of northern Luzon, the areas under signals number 2 and 1 are already experiencing rains from the typhoon's rain bands. The typhoon-enhanced southwest monsoon or Habagat, meanwhile, is also bringing scattered to occasional rains over central Luzon, Calabarzon, Mimaropa, Bicol region, and western Visayas. Flooding and landslides are likely in these areas. Jenny will continue to steadily weaken as dry air enters its core and the changing of wind speed and direction in Luzon Strait becomes harsher. It will be closest to Batanes Wednesday when strong winds and heavy rains will be felt most. Jenny may make landfall over southern Taiwan late Wednesday or early Thursday and will be out of the Philippine area of responsibility between late morning and afternoon of Thursday. The typhoon's rain bands will continue to affect northern Luzon through Wednesday or Thursday, while the enhanced Habagat will affect the western section of Luzon until Friday. And here in Metro Manila, it is now gloomy and scattered rains are expected throughout the day. The same weather condition is expected until Friday.
The Association of Southeast Asian Nations recently concluded its first joint naval exercises without any outside power. And as this report tells us, the drills, which focus on disaster response, took place near waters China claims as its own.
The Association of Southeast Asian Nations, or ASEAN, recently wrapped up its inaugural naval drills called the ASEAN Solidarity Exercise on September 23rd. Hosted by Indonesia, the exercises were focused on coordinated disaster response in a region vulnerable to tsunamis and other extreme weather events. Another goal, expand military ties and military cooperation between ASEAN nations.
ASEAN is not only a symbol of solidarity, cooperation, and close friendship between us, but also a manifestation of military strength from ASEAN members.
This year's exercises were held in the South Natuna Sea. It borders the North Natuna Sea, part of which China claims as part of its expansive territory in the larger South China Sea. According to Indonesian Navy Commodore Muhammad Taufik, the region was chosen purposely.
From our perspective, because this is the first exercise conducted, so we think that the area in Natuna and Batam is the closest area near to neighboring states.
But the location of the joint exercises did not escape the attention of Beijing, which in August had published a new map reiterating its claims in the South China Sea.
We have a clear and consistent position on the South China Sea.
While the exercises were focused on natural disaster response, piracy and rescue operations, analysts like Carl Baker of the Pacific Forum say they are also an opportunity for ASEAN countries to make a statement.
They've both done ASEAN-US exercises, ASEAN-China exercises. This is, the first one that's all ASEAN. And so I think that that's significant.
Baker also notes how the choice of location also showed ASEAN pragmatism, championed by Indonesia.
Well, remember that the initial proposal was to do the exercise in the North Natuna Sea, and the way they satisfied Cambodia was to move it in the South Natuna Sea, which is less controversial because it's clearly outside of the supposed nine-dash line that China has drawn in that region.
Brunei, Malaysia, and Singapore sent warships and combat personnel to the exercise. The Philippines, Cambodia, Laos, Myanmar, Vietnam, and Thailand sent observers, as did aspiring ASEAN member East Timor. For Indra Yoga in Batam, Indonesia, Nova Purwadi, VOA News.
Filipino and American troops begin their annual joint naval drills in the Philippines, along with the navies of seven other countries. Bianca Dava tells us more.
The Philippines and the United States kicked off their annual bilateral Navy-to-Navy drills, dubbed Exercise Sama-Sama, at the Philippine Navy headquarters in Manila on Monday. Philippine Navy Flag Officer in Command, Vice Admiral Toribio Adasi Jr. said this year's iteration of Exercise Sama-Sama aims to strengthen further international defense cooperation between the Philippines and the U.S. For U.S. 7th Fleet Commander Vice Admiral Carl Thomas, the drills will also inculcate in the navies of both countries the doctrine of the rules-based international order.
The ruling of the International Tribunal speaks for itself, and the ruling upheld the sovereign rights of the Filipinos in the West Philippine Sea, and that is basically following international law, and this is what we promote.
I think what we want is the normal rules-based international order that has served our region so well by operating and following laws that have been upheld and are very clearly stated in documents like the United Nations Convention Law of the Sea, and demonstrating that we know how to operate in accordance with the rule of the law, we decrease the chance for miscalculation.
A total of 733 Navy troops from the Philippines and 632 from the U.S. will participate in the two-week military drills. For the second year in a row, the exercise will also include other participants from Japan, the United Kingdom, Canada, France, and Australia. They will take part in subject matter expert exchanges and events related to humanitarian assistance and disaster response. Members of the Royal New Zealand Navy and Indonesian Navy will also join as observers.
We thought of expanding it to become a multilateral exercise. Four nations have sent their ships for some exercises at sea, but other navies will participate in other events like HADR, subject matter expert exchanges. So not all the eight participating countries will do exercises at sea. Some are observers, some are sending their subject matter experts for discussions on several issues.
What does that demonstrate? And I think that it's really important that we all recognize that the global maritime commons are used by everybody, and everybody wants the global maritime commons to be free and open.
The drills will be conducted in Metro Manila and at the Naval Forces Southern Luzon. Naval assets such as the BRP Antonio Luna, AW-109 naval helicopter, and C-90 aircraft will be utilized throughout the exercise. The annual exercise Sama-Sama comes on the heels of fresh tension between Manila and Beijing over the West Philippine Sea, where massive coral damage has been observed. The Philippines suspects this could be China's doing. China has also consistently driven away Filipino fishermen from Scarborough Shoal and harassed Philippine ships on rotation and resupply missions in the West Philippine Sea. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News.